I'm Professor Sharke Manisha. Today's our lecture is eighth lecture. Today we are going to start the second unit. But before we that, what we have seen in those lectures, first to seven lectures, we have completed our first unit. That is, what is the first unit? Introduction to Management Concepts and Managerial Skills. हे युनिट आपण संपवलेलं आहे मुलांनो. आणि आज आपल्याला सेकंड युनिट सुरुवात करायची आहे. काय आहे सेकंड युनिटचं नाव? प्लॅनिंग अँड ऑर्गनायझिंग ॲट सुपरवायझरी लेवल. व्हॉट इज सेकंड युनिट? प्लॅनिंग अँड ऑर्गनायझिंग ॲट सुपरवायझरी लेवल. ओके, सो स्टुडंट्स, इन दिस युनिट सेकंड what we have to see, first of all, what is mean by planning, what are the plannings at supervisory level, then organizing at supervisory level. Okay, and in planning at supervisory level, what we have to see, what are the different plannings done by supervisor, then planning activities and detailing. Okay, then also we have to see prescribing standard forms for various activities. Then we have to see in planning budgeting for materials and manpower. Okay, and in organizing at supervisory level, what we have to see, organizing the physical resources for that particular organization. Okay, then also we have to see matching human need with job needs, matching human needs with job needs. Then we have to see allotment of task to individuals and establishing relationship among persons working in group. So these are the points we have to see in this second unit. So we will start now. First one is content one, that is, what is mean by planning? Okay, in content one, what we have to see, see. पहिल्यांदा आपल्याला बघायचं आहे प्लॅनिंग म्हणजे काय, कशा पद्धतीने प्लॅनिंग करायचं, नेचर ऑफ द प्लॅनिंग. ओके, देन वाय प्लॅनिंग ऑर इम्पॉर्टन्स अँड नीड ऑफ प्लॅनिंग, वाय प्लॅनिंग इज नेसेसरी इन एनी ऑर्गनायझेशन ऑर इन्स्टिट्यूशन. देन वी हॅव टू सी वॉट आर द डिफरंट टाईप्स ऑफ प्लॅनिंग. देन ऑल्सो वी हॅव टू सी द स्टेप्स इन प्लॅनिंग. ओके, अँड प्लॅनिंग एक्झिक्युशन अँड कंट्रोलिंग प्रोसेस. सो दीज आर द पॉइंट्स विच वी हॅव टू सी टुडे. So what I told you, what we have to see now, what is mean by planning, nature of planning, then why planning is necessary, then what are the different types of planning, what are the different steps in planning. Okay, and also we have to see the planning execution and controlling process. Okay, so one by one we will see these students. Now first of all we will see व्हॉट इज मीन बाय प्लॅनिंग. तर मुलांना प्लॅनिंग म्हणजे काय? प्लॅन तुम्ही करत असाल ना कुठल्याही गोष्टीचा. सपोज उद्या तुम्हाला कुठेतरी बाहेर जायचं आहे तर त्याचं प्लॅन तुम्ही करता. मग वेदर इट इज इनफॉर्मल सिच्युएशन ऑर इनफॉर्मल सिच्युएशन, देअर शुड बी प्लॅनिंग फॉर एनी इव्हेंट ऑर ऍक्टिव्हिटी. सो व्हाईल प्लॅनिंग वी टेक द स्टॉक ऑफ सिच्युएशन. जेव्हा आपण प्लॅनिंग करतो तेव्हा आपण कशाची काळजी घेतो? आपल्याकडे कशा पद्धतीची सिच्युएशन पुढे असणार आहे. सो वेअर वी आर ॲट प्रेझेंट, वेअर वी आर वेन वी आर गोइंग टू मेक प्लॅनिंग फॉर एनी इव्हेंट ऑर ॲक्टिव्हिटी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हॅव टू थिंक ऑर वी शुड थिंक वेअर वी आर. देन यू हॅव टू डिसाइड ऑन वेअर वी वॉन्ट टू गो. आता आपण कुठे आहोत, याच्या पुढे आपल्याला काय करायचे आहे किंवा काय प्रोसेस करायचे आहे, अँड देन यू हॅव टू डिसाइड द पाथ टू रीच देअर. कुठल्या मार्गाने आपल्याला तिथपर्यंत पोहोचायचं आहे. सो दॅट पाथ इज नथिंग बट कॉल्ड ॲज अ प्लॅन. पहा काय काय गोष्टी याच्यामध्ये येतात. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हॅव टू टेक इन टू कन्सिडरेशन द स्टॉक ऑफ सिच्युएशन. देन वेअर वी आर, तुम्ही सपोज फॉर एक्झाम्पल तुम्ही प्लॅनिंग करताय तर तुम्हाला विचार करायचा आहे की तुम्ही आता सध्या कुठे आहात, ॲट विच पोझिशन यू आर स्टिल. देन यू हॅव टू डिसाइडेड वेअर यू वॉन्ट टू गो. By using these steps, you have to decide where you want to go and decide, you have to decide a path to reach at your goal. So that path is called as plan. So it is said that good plan is like a road map. Okay. It shows the final destination and usually the best way to get there. So planning is called as the best way to reach at your destination, like road map. Understood? Okay. Then students, we will continue with this. Planning is the first and foremost step in the process of management of any activity at the level of individual or an organization of any type. So what you have to remember? Planning is the first and very important step in the process of management. It is the duty of the management to make plan of any event or any activity. Okay. So organization may be family. My organization kon asu shakta? May be family, may be business, or may be non-business. So these types of organization or any other type of organizations, large or small. Okay. Organizations madhe kay kay eta sangitla mi tumhala? Family, maybe family, maybe business or non-business organizations. So any other type of organizations, whether it is large or whether it is small. So however, it is essential to decide goals and objectives. What is to be done? That you have to think first of all in your mind first, and for the achievement of the same, plans are made and executed. So what you have decided, you have to study on that, and according to that you have to go forward for to achieve your goal or success. Okay. So students, remember, it is a mental process or activity. Planning is called as a mental process or activity. So first, the plans are made at mental level, focusing on desired goals. Planning kasha paddhatine keli jate? At the starting, it should be at your mental level, which is focused on your desired goals. After that, what is there? Thereafter, they are put on paper as appropriate actions plans. So sagat adhi aplela mind madhe create karayacha ekadya goshtiche planning, and after that you have to put it on paper, and then you have to circulate to the employees or workers. Okay. So top management, with the help of middle and lower level of management, execute them in time bound manner to achieve desired goals. So it is the students, it is the duty of the top management, with the help of lower management and middle management, they have to execute whatever plan they have made. Okay. Students, our second point is nature of planning. आता प्लॅनिंग म्हणजे काय हे तुम्हाला कळलं. नाव वी विल सी व्हॉट टाईप ऑफ नेचर शुड बी देअर प्लॅनिंग. सो प्लॅनिंग इज ऑलवेज फ्युचर ओरिएंटेड. प्लॅनिंग कधी पास्ट असतं का मुलांना? नो, इट शुड बी फ्युचर ओरिएंटेड. सो वी मेक प्लॅन्स फॉर नेक्स्ट डे और कमिंग वीक और कमिंग मंथ और कमिंग इयर और कमिंग इयर्स. बघा, कधी कधीच आपण प्लॅनिंग करू शकतो ऍट इंडिव्हिज्युअल लेवल ऑल्सो और as a management also. So we make plans for next day. उद्याचं तुम्ही as individual, जर आपण एक्झाम्पल घेतलं तर तुम्ही उद्या काय करायचं आहे याचं प्लॅनिंग करू शकता. जर तुमची एक्झाम जवळ आलेली आहे तर तुम्ही 8 दिवसाचं, 15 दिवसाचं, 2 महिन्यांचं प्लॅनिंग तुम्ही करू शकता. ओके. सो वी मेक प्लॅन्स फॉर नेक्स्ट डे और कमिंग वीक और मंथ और इयर और कमिंग इयर्स. सो वी नेवर प्लॅन फॉर द पास्ट. Remember students, we never plan for the past. भूतकाळात झालेला गोष्टीचा आपण प्लॅन करतो का? नाही. किंवा भूतकाळासाठी प्लॅन करतो का? नो. सो रिमेंबर, वी नेवर प्लॅन फॉर द past. So very simple. Simply you have to put when we do planning. Okay, very simply put when we do planning, we try to answer questions. Swatala's question which are right, when you are individually making planning or by management. So what, for what purpose you are planning? Why? Kashasathi? Who is doing planning? When it is implemented? Where? For what purpose? How? Kasha paddhatine? And the answers we get become the basis of the planning. And according to these questions, you have to make planning step by step. This is the nature of planning. Okay. See. So, according to this Knuth and O'Donnell, what he said? Planning is deciding in advance. Kadhi keli jati planning? Advance madhe. What to do? How to do it, when to do it, and who is to do it. So these are the factors important for making plan. So it bridges the gap from where we are and to where we want to go. It is in essence the exercise of foresight. Durudrushti asli paije jeva apan planning karto. So these questions, students, where, when, how, what, who, why, should be asked while before making planning. Okay. Then students, we will see why planning is important, or what is the need and importance of planning in any organization. So students, unless planning is done, no activity can start and nothing can be done. जोपर्यंत आपण प्लॅनिंग करत नाही कुठल्याही गोष्टीचं, तोपर्यंत कुठलीही ऍक्टिव्हिटी घडत नाही. अनलेस प्लॅनिंग इज डन, नो ऍक्टिव्हिटी कॅन स्टार्ट अँड नथिंग कॅन बी डन. म्हणजे जोपर्यंत आपण कुठल्याही गोष्टीची प्लॅनिंग करत नाही, तोपर्यंत आपली गोष्ट सक्सेसफुल होणार नाही, कुठलीही ऍक्टिव्हिटी असू देत किंवा इव्हेंट असू देत. ओके. द पर्सन्स or the organizations that plan better and in time, म्हणजे individually आपण planning करू शकतो मगाशी सांगितल्याप्रमाणे, or the organizations as the top management that plan better and in time so that always succeed to achieve their goals. So planning is very important before starting any activity or any event, that you have to remember. So planning creates a focus and direction towards goal. The planning kya karta, it focus on directions and what are your goals. Okay. Planning creates focus and directions, what is your goal. So planning minimizes the risk of failure and uncertainty. म्हणजे प्लॅनिंग जर नाही केलं तर काय होईल, तिथे तुमच्या इव्हेंटमध्ये कुठल्याही ऍक्टिव्हिटीमध्ये प्रोसेसमध्ये फेल्युअर येऊ शकतं किंवा खात्री तुम्हाला नसेल की हे चांगल्या पद्धतीने होईल. पण जर प्लॅनिंग असेल तर काय होईल, इट मिनिमायझेस द रिस्क ऑफ फेल्युअर. ओके, दॅट यू हॅव टू रिमेंबर. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट आहे planning facilitate control. Planning mule kay hota, it should be control on any activity. In absence of planning, if we don't know what is to be done and controlled, no control is possible. Jar swatalas maiti nasel yacha madhe aplyala kay karayche, planning as nasel, so one cannot do anything. So planning improves efficiency and effectiveness of any activity or process and ensures optimum utilization of resources. Planning kya karta, it improves efficiency of any work, any activity, effectiveness of any activity or process, and ensures khatri dete kashachi optimum युटिलायझेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. जे काही रिसोर्सेस आपण प्लॅनिंगमध्ये घेतले होते ते ऑप्टिमाइज केले जातात की नाही. सो इट मस्ट बी केप्ट इन माइंड दॅट प्लॅनिंग इज नॉट अ वन टाइम अफेअर बट कंटिन्युअस प्रोसेस. सो प्लॅनिंग इज अ कंटिन्युअस प्रोसेस. सो यू हॅव टू डू कंटिन्युअस अपडेटिंग और कोर्स करेक्शन अकॉर्डिंग टू चेंजिंग सिच्युएशन और कॉन्टिजेंसीज. सो वॉट यू हॅव टू डू इफ यू आर द प्लॅनर, यू हॅव टू डू कंटिन्युअस अपडेशन टू हुम यू आर गोइंग टू प्रोव्हाइड युअर प्लॅनिंग. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, ॲज अ टॉप मॅनेजमेंट यू कॅन प्रोव्हाइड दिस प्लॅनिंग टू द एम्प्लॉईज और वर्कर्स और स्टाफ्स. ओके, देन स्टुडंट्स, वी हॅव टू सी वॉट आर द डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्लॅनिंग. आतापर्यंत काय काय पाहिलं आपण? वॉट इज मीन बाय प्लॅनिंग? प्लॅनिंग म्हणजे काय? कुठले कुठले फॅक्टर्स नेसेसरी असतात प्लॅनिंगसाठी? वॉट इज द नेचर ऑफ द प्लॅनिंग आहे ते सुद्धा आपण बघितलेलं आहे. ओके, नाव वी विल सी वॉट आर द डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्लॅनिंग. सो स्टुडंट्स, प्लॅनिंग कॅन बी क्लासिफाईड ॲज बिलो. सी, नंबर वन, कव्हरेज ऑफ ऍक्टिव्हिटी. प्लॅनिंगमध्ये पहिला घटक काय असणार आहे? कव्हरेज ऑफ ऍक्टिव्हिटी. सेकंड आहे इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ कंटेंट्स, इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ कंटेंट्स. थर्ड आहे टाइम पिरियड इन्वॉल्व्ड, ती ऍक्टिव्हिटी कम्प्लीट व्हायला किती वेळ लागणार आहे, टाइम पिरियड इन्वॉल्व्ड. अँड फोर्थ वन इज अप्रोच अडॉप्टेड. सो दीज आर द फोर टाइप्स ऑफ प्लॅनिंग विच वी हॅव टू सी नाव. सो फर्स्ट वन इज कव्हरेज ऑफ ऍक्टिव्हिटी. सो कॉर्पोरेट SBU level and departmental level, that functional, that is planning, it is called as coverage of activity. It is taken place at corporate level, SBU level and departmental level. Okay, then second type is importance of content. So strategic and tactical planning is important. Strategic and tactical planning is important in importance of content. Then time period involved, long term, short term, medium term, what type of planning you are going to do, that is type of one plan, that is time period involved. Then approach adopted, proactive and reactive planning, which we have seen in the first unit. Okay, proactive and reactive planning. So these are the classifications are important for the planning. So there are other types also which we are going to now discuss. Hey, samajle ka? Types of planning, have you understood? Kay hai pahila? Coverage of activity. Second, importance of contents. Third, time period involved. And fourth, approach adopted. Okay, now students, we have to see what are the different steps in planning. Ata apan baghitle types, ata apan baghnar ahot what are the different steps in planning or process of planning, step by step how the process, planning process takes place. So the planning process is different from one plan to another and one organization to another. प्रत्येक ऑर्गनायझेशनचे स्टेप्स प्लॅनिंगचे वेगवेगळे असतात, किंवा इंडिव्हिज्युअली जे कोणी प्लॅनिंग करत असतात त्यांचे स्टेप्स वेगवेगळे असतात. सो यू हॅव टू रिमेंबर द प्लॅनिंग प्रोसेस इज डिफरंट फ्रॉम वन प्लॅन टू अनदर अँड वन ऑर्गनायझेशन टू अनदर ऑर्गनायझेशन. So the steps generally involved in planning, see, first one is perception of opportunities. Okay, second one is establishment of objectives, then planning premises, then identification of alternative, then evaluation of alternative, okay, choice of alternative, then formulation of supporting plan and establishing situations of activities. So these are the steps which are taken place in planning process. Ha lakshat thevayche, perception of opportunities, then establishment of objectives, then planning premises, then identification of alternative, evaluation of alternative, choice of alternative, formulation of supporting plan, establishing sequence of activities, that you have to remember. Okay, now we will go ahead. Planning, execution and controlling process. Next point I have la, planning, execution and controlling process. So see the diagram, planning process, controlling process and executive process. See, controlling process, planning process, executing planning process, executing. Okay, so in controlling process and planning process, between changes are there, and in planning process and executing process, plans are there, and in all between them there is a performance data and also correction is there. So have you understood this diagram? Planning process, there is a correlation between controlling process, the changes are there, planning process and executing process, plans are there. Then performance data between controlling process and executing process, correction is there in controlling process and executing process. Okay, so this is all about, students, this is all about our content one. Okay, in content one what we have seen, just we will see काय काय बघितलं आपण कंटेंट वन मध्ये. प्लॅनिंग बघितलं, व्हॉट इज मीन बाय प्लॅनिंग, नेचर ऑफ प्लॅनिंग, वाय प्लॅनिंग ऑर इम्पॉर्टन्स अँड नीड ऑफ प्लॅनिंग, देन व्हॉट आर द डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्लॅनिंग वी हॅव सीन. ओके, देन स्टेप्स इन प्लॅनिंग वी हॅव सीन, अँड ऑल्सो वी हॅव सीन प्लॅनिंग, एक्झिक्युशन अँड कंट्रोलिंग प्रोसेस. ओके, नाव वी हॅव टू सी द कंटेंट टू. ओके, wait a minute, content 2. Okay, see content 2. In content 2 what we have to see, students, concept of soft and hard side of planning, concept and soft and hard side of planning, concept of soft and hard side of planning. Second point, we have to see the levels of management with functions. फर्स्ट युनिटमध्ये आपण बघितलेलं होतं मुलांनो, टॉप लेवल, मिडल लेवल, लोअर लेवल, वर्कर्स, ओके, मॅनेजमेंट लेवल्स बघितले होते. तर त्याच्यावरती आपल्याला पाहायचं आहे लेवल्स ऑफ मॅनेजमेंट विथ देअर फंक्शन्स, देन फंक्शन्स अँड ड्युटीज ऑफ अ सुपरवायझर. व्हॉट आर द डिफरंट फंक्शन्स, व्हॉट आर द डिफरंट फंक्शन्स अँड ड्युटीज ऑफ द सुपरवायझर, दॅट वी हॅव टू सी हिअर. देन प्लॅनिंग ॲट सुपरवायझरी लेवल अँड contingencies or situational planning, that also point we have to see here. Situational planning, according to situation what type of planning should be there, or what are the changes should be there, that we have to see in this point. And at last we have to see the summary of today's lecture. Okay, so we will go first point in content 2. What is first point? Concept of soft and hard side of planning. Concept of soft and hard side of planning. So students, planning is mental process. Remember, Suratilas mi sangitla hota what is mean by planning. So planning is a mental process, and top managers generate long term plans and policies to achieve organizational goals. And to make plan is whose duty it is at the organizational level? It is the duty of the top management or top managers generate long-term plans and policies to achieve organizational goals. So remember, planning is a mental process, and top managers generate long-term plans and policies to achieve ऑर्गनायझेशनल गोल्स. जे काही ऑर्गनायझेशनचे एम असेल, गोल असेल, ते पूर्ण करण्यासाठी who work on that top managers. So it is the duty of the top managers to handle the process very carefully. So middle level managers or departmental heads in consultation with top managers create action plans or functional plans which are first put on paper. So according to the guidance of the top managers, middle and what we can say HODs, middle people and HODs, what they do, they can make consultation with top managers and create action plans or functional plans, we can say that, which are first put on paper. So top management only guide the middle level people and HODs, head of the department. So both the steps are as above are the soft side of planning. Top managers ची काय ड्यूटी असणार आहे टू गाइड द मिडल लेवल पीपल अँड एच ओ डीज ओके मिडल लेवल मॅनेजर वी कॅन सी दॅट सो बोथ दीज स्टेप्स आर ॲज अबोव आर द सॉफ्ट साइड ऑफ प्लॅनिंग सो विच डिसाइड्स वॉट इज टू बी डन अँड हाऊ इट इज टू बी डन ओके सो हाऊ एव्हर अनलेस दीज ऍक्शन प्लॅन्स आर इम्प्लिमेंटेड ऑर एक्झिक्युटेड फिजिकली बाय समवन with the help of given resources in a time bound manner, no results will be achieved. हे जे प्लॅनिंग दिलेलं आहे टॉप मॅनेजरने गाईड करून कोणाला मिडल लेवल मॅनेजर्सला आणि हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट्सला जर त्याच्यावरती व्यवस्थित ऍक्शन प्लॅन झाला नाही तर काय होईल व्यवस्थित इम्प्लिमेंटेशन झालं नाही what happened? With the help of given resources in time bound manner, no result will be found. So it is the duty of the middle level manager and head of the departments to make action plans and according to implement these plans to the workers or employees. So this is hard or physical side of planning. This is hard and physical side of planning. Operational plans are made on the basis of functional plans and are executed by middle level of managers with the help of lower level of managers, that is because we can say that section heads or supervisors. Okay, so this is just like passing the baton on or creating a chain of actions. So there is a correlation, student, top managers, then middle manager, and then HOD is head of the departments, that you have to remember. Okay, now we will see, students, what is the concept of soft and hard side plan. Concept of soft and hard side planning. Okay, so understand that lower level management or supervisors are there in all types of industries. Lower level che managers ani head of the departments kiwa apan kay mhanu tanna supervisors they are available or in all types of industries. मग कुठल्या कुठल्या इंडस्ट्रीज असतील, इंजिनिअरिंग फील्ड असेल, मग ते मेकॅनिकल असेल, इलेक्ट्रिकल असेल, केमिकल इंडस्ट्री असेल किंवा कन्स्ट्रक्शन साईड असेल. हुज ॲक्शन इज द सब्जेक्ट मॅटर ऑफ द डिस्कशन ऑफ दिस पार्ट. तर इथे कोण काम करतं? लोअर लेवल मॅनेजमेंट और सुपरवायझर्स. ओके, so they are responsible for getting work done from the workers as per the instructions and guidelines received from the top by following certain steps or procedures. The lower level of management la kiwa supervisor la guidelines kona kadna yetat mulanno? Top management kadna. Tar he tumhala lakshat thevayche, they are responsible. Who are responsible? Lower level management of supervisors for getting work done from the workers as per the instructions and guidelines given by top management. We will take one example, students. Consider arrangement of the raw material. Arrangement aplyala karayche, for example, raw material ahe ki nahi. So in mechanical engineering workshop he has to arrange for still to process on machines or components and hardware for assembly, but in construction part there is a difference between in two examples we are taking. First, you have to consider the arrangement of the raw material in mechanical engineering industry, and another example is in construction industry. What is the difference? Raw material, that we will see. So in mechanical engineering, what happened? Workshop he has to arrange workshop for steel to process on machines, how to make process on machine or components and hardware. Okay, but in construction industry, what happened? The manager, lower level manager, he has to arrange for construction steel, cement, bricks and so on. Okay, however, for the sake of our discussion, we will limit ourselves to engineering industry or a workplace. Okay, so students, see the here level of management with functions. See the diagram. Level of management with its functions. So see, first of all, we will see there are three types of planning. Strategic planning, it is called as the long-term planning. Then tactical planning, it is called as medium-term planning. Okay, and operational planning is called as short-term planning. So level of management, see here, top level, middle level, lower level and workers. The top level management kiwa managers tyancha kay kaam asto, middle level supervisor kiwa middle level managers cha kay kaam asto, ani lower level. Okay, so top level madhe kay asto mulanno paha, board of directors and chief executive officers. Board of directors and chief executive officers are a top level management, and what they do? They define the objectives and formulating the policies. They define what is the objective, goal, aim behind this activity or event according to their organization. Then middle level managers, what they do? They are called as the departmental heads and managers, and they identify the departmental objectives and guiding the lower level towards the achievement of these objectives. So middle level managers, what they do? They identify the departmental objective. Top level management, their objective is formulating process or different policies. Okay, and lower level madhe kon yeto mulanno, supervisors or foreman. Okay, supervisors kay tanchi kay duty hai mag, they carry out the operations and their supervisions. Supervisors duty is to carry out the operations, whatever work is assigned to them, they are, this is done by their employees or workers. Okay, so this is all about levels of management with their function. Understood? Okay, now we will see what are the different functions or duties of the supervisory level students. Functions or duties. Okay, supervising level la function kay ahe pa, to assign jobs and tasks to various workers. Supervisors cha kaam kay ahe te mi sangte mulano, it is the duty of the supervisor to assign job and give different tasks to the various workers. Okay, then to guide and instruct workers for day-to-day activities. He is the responsible for the quality and quantity production. This supervisor is responsible for what? Quality and quantity of the production. It is the duty of the supervisor to create and maintain safe working conditions. It is the duty of the supervisor to act as a link and communicate between top management and workers. Okay, it is the duty of the supervisor to solve grievances, means problems of the workers. It is also duty of the supervisor to provide necessary training to the workers and motivate them, to give different types of training and give motivation. It is duty of the supervisor. It is also one duty of the supervisor to arrange necessary materials, machines, tools, etc. for their particular department. It is also duty of the supervisor to prepare periodical reports about the performance of the workers and their section. And most important function of the supervisor is to ensure discipline in the enterprise, in the any organization. So these are all functions or duties of the supervisors. Okay. So what should be the planning at a supervisory level? We have to see, students. Within 5 minutes, we will conclude this lecture. What is the planning at supervisory level? So supervisors make short-term planning, which can involve scheduling daily activities, machine, raw material, manpower, also planning and completing production or target of its section. So it is the, what is the planning by supervisor here? Supervisors make short-term planning, for example, one-day planning, which can involve काय काय असतं त्याच्यामध्ये, scheduling असतं, daily activities, काय काय करायचं त्याचं schedule केलं जातं. त्यानंतर मशीनरीज ओके आहेत का, वर्किंग मध्ये आहेत का ते पाहिलं जातं. रॉ मटेरियल अवेलेबल आहे का, त्यानंतर मॅनपॉवर आहे का, मॅनपॉवर प्लॅनिंग ते पाहिलं जातं त्यांच्याकडनं. अँड कम्प्लिटिंग प्रोडक्शन टार्गेट ऑफ इज सेक्शन. सो इट इज द ड्युटी ऑफ द सुपरवायझर लेवल. सो सुपरवायझर इज अ पर्सन हु इज इन चार्ज ऑफ द कोऑर्डिनेटर्स अँड ऍक्टिव्हिटीज ऑफ अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्कर्स एंगेज इन रिलेटेड ऍक्टिव्हिटीज ऑफ इज सेक्शन. सो ज्या काही त्याच्या सेक्शनमध्ये वेगवेगळे ऍक्टिव्हिटीज होत असतात ते व्यवस्थित चालू आहेत का, रनिंगमध्ये आहेत का, हे पाहण्याचं काम कोणाचं असतं मुलांनो? सुपरवायझर. ओके, सो ही इज अ फ्रंट लाईन मॅनेजर, वी कॅन कॉल हिम. ही इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर गेटिंग द वर्क डन फ्रॉम द वर्कर्स विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू प्लान्स अँड पॉलिसीज सेट बाय द मॅनेजमेंट. टॉप मॅनेजमेंटने ज्या पद्धतीने प्लॅनिंग किंवा रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी दिलेली असते हे करून घ्यायचं वर्करकडून, ते योग्य पद्धतीने होतं का नाही हे पाहण्याचं काम कोणाचं असतं? सुपरवायझरचं. सो अ सुपरवायझर कॅन प्लॅन, डायरेक्ट, मोटिवेट अँड मॉनिटर द वर्क. In short, we can say that supervisor can make plan, give direction, motivate and monitor the work done by the employees or workers. So he takes care of workflow. काम कशा पद्धतीने चालू आहे याची काळजी कोणाकडून घेतली जाते? सुपरवायझर कडून. सो सुपरवायझर प्लॅन्स द बजेट रिलेटेड टू मॅन पॉवर, ओव्हरहेड, रॉ मटेरियल अँड अदर स्मॉल एक्सपेन्सेस. तर बजेट सँक्शन करण्याचं, करून घेण्याचं काम हे देखील सुपरवायझर्सचं असतं. ओके, सो सक्सेस ऑफ एनी वर्क ऑलवेज डिपेंड्स अपॉन अ डिग्री ऑफ अडॉप्शन, इट्स फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी अँड इफिशियंट हँडलिंग ऑफ चेंजिंग कंडिशन्स. इट इज कॉल्ड अ सिच्युएशनल प्लॅनिंग. अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिच्युएशन हाऊ द प्लॅनिंग चेंज. ओके, so in case any deviation in implementing any plan, the supervisor needs, what he needs, keeping all options open approach all the time. That is situational. The situation vegli jali ta tya paddhatine planning madhe change karta alo pahije supervisor la. So students, we have seen today what it mean by planning, what are the different types of planning. There are three major types of plan we have seen: strategic, tactical and operational, long term, short term and middle term. Okay, so diploma students join organizations at what we can say, diploma students join organizations at supervisory level, and so it is important for you students to understand planning and execution at that level. That we have seen today. This is helpful for you. Okay. Thank you.